What's happening?
And you are tapped in.
Welcome to another episode of
PakTalk.
PakTalk.
We'll make the bag walk. You feel me? Let's go.
We got some special folks in the building.
Hold on.
What are you saying? Hold on.
Benny.
Hold on.
Always you, Shane.
You feel me? Let's go.
Biggest on
the block.
Hold
on. It's biggest on the block, boy.
Biggest on the block.
Say less. Remember shopping that.
Pay left. I love my other than he'll rap anyone here in the fuck. And then we got the, you know,
yeah, you know, they call me TaxFree Whoop.
TaxFree
Whoop. And you know, man, BlockBoy Hancho.
You feel me? You know?
BlockBoy certified.
I see it's TaxFree in the building, you know what I'm talking about? Hancho rolling something up as we speak, that's, you know what I'm saying? Mando.
Yes, sir.
And there he is. The Poochie. But, what's happening?
What's happening?
Yeah, I'm shaking, cutting up. Ooh, hey, you see Benny with the fresh gear, too?
Come on, bro.
Make sure you tap in soon, because we got some gold. We got some gold tags dropping. That's an exclusive
we
shit.
We got some Willy Wonka shit. We got some shit that's limited.
You're going to have to tap in early, or you will miss it. You got to tap in early, or you will miss it. So make sure you tap in with my bro.
Subscribe. You know what I'm saying?
Subscribe. Tap in early or you will miss the merchandise.
Everything, you mean? Whatever you want us to talk about, comment. We're going to go live on one of these, you know what I'm saying? Then y'all can comment there and tell us what you want to talk about for right now. Comment, and you know what I'm saying? We're going to take your advice and we'll talk about it later. You feel me? But for right now, we're going to get involved right here with Woo, man.
My boy right here. It's my Tax City partner, bro. Come on.
So they got an album.
It's gold.
Tax City.
Tax City. If you ain't heard it, better go get that shit.
Man, if you ain't heard, I don't know.
Hey, hardest shit in the speakers, man.
Man, come on, man.
Hardest shit in the speakers, man.
It's called unity, bro. It's called just being real, real recognized, real, bro. Since I met Whoop at this little show, bro. Since then, we locked in, we got that. And then guess what, man? We got an album called A Three-Headed Dragon next, nigga. Yes, all three of us, nigga.
Yes, sir.
Bro,
yes,
it's just all love, bro.
And you gotta understand, us going into the music, we wasn't even like, we didn't even know who to look to or look whatever, you know what I'm saying? We go to a show, Benny's already rocking, so we Pakcity go up to the show. We see Whoop on stage, and mind you, we don't know nobody.
We ain't on no
street shit when it comes to the music shit. We keep everything separate, you feel me? So we out there showing love, you know what I mean? If we out there in the show and we see you, and you rocking, and we look at you, and we're like, damn, they go crazy, we fucking with you, you know what I'm saying? Whoop was out there with Lil Dang. Shout out Lil Dang,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He'll be
Dang,
on the show,
man.
You know what I'm saying? He'll be on one, but they was killing the fucking show.
They was
going, talking back and forth. I love that
they
shit.
They was doing that shit, man.
I didn't even know what song, but...
Me and Richard, all three of us, and Richard tells us, hey, I looked at no, Richard wasn't there on this one.
Was he? He was
okay,
there.
Okay, yeah, because I remember I told y'all it was on Victorian.
It was on Victorian.
My bad. I mean, we're in the crowd, and we're like, you know what I mean? It was a little small, little show, but
it was cool, though.
In the crowd, I was like, hey, bro, and I ain't gonna lie, because I mean, but who really be? I mean, I seen this nigga perform, bro. I was like, nigga, let's go watch this nigga,
yeah,
bro. Who the
hell
is this?
Yeah, they lit up.
Y'all was up there doing some shit.
Christian even brought us to our attention.
Hey, Christian was there?
Yeah. He was like, they go crazy.
Oh, the pictures. We got pictures. I got them pictures. Matter of fact,
that was the day we locked in.
We locked in. And what
they say, Destiny is, you feel me? Destiny is meant. You know what I mean?
And what I seen is, not to cut
Destiny be meant.
But what I seen was, and I fuck with you because you guys were on that hype. We seen you on another show, and I was like, damn, they're really moving, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I like their sound, so let's lock it in. And then as soon as I met you, you record at the house at all times. Yeah, you'll pull into studios because we've been
Benny
Shimo,
pulled up
shout
on
Shimo.
Us.
Yeah, Benny pulled up.
Yeah, the first time Benny pulled up on us, yeah, we did like hella songs.
Dude, that's three there too. Remember that nigga?
Yeah, we made like eight songs down that day.
Bro, we were crazy that night, nigga. We was chilling, bro.
Tell you that for real. We versatile, like you were just saying on that three-headed dragon. That's gonna be hard as hell.
Yeah, that's
it give you three different stories. You feel me? It's
exactly.
Like it give you three different stories, three different aspects of poverty, three different aspects of the struggle. You feel me? It's like,
and they're all certified.
And they're all certified, verified aspects. So it's like if you love music, you for surely gonna listen. You know what I mean? If not, you living under a rock. Like
right,
you know what I mean?
Real shit.
You know what I mean? Like for
fucking
real,
Patrick ass niggas, huh?
Like real. For real, and it's like, and it's like
really
we giving
the
versatile aspects. We throwing it back with old school beats and all type of shit. So it's like we taking it back to old school hip hop.
And this man right here, you know what I'm saying? We met, you know what I mean? Their brothers, Hancho, he do something. You know what I mean?
Man,
he got
different show.
You got a project coming out. What you gonna call the project?
Vibe with me.
Vibe with me.
Yes,
and
sir.
You know he sings. raps. Yes, he does everything, you know what I mean? So harmonizes. And then so he yes, so I had heard Hancho. I heard you on a song. I ain't never even seen your face. I didn't know who you
it
were.
It was from that and night we met.
That night when we was laying the song down. Yeah. So that song, I was like, holy shit. I was like, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? And then they never dropped it because they didn't get the mixing and this and that. So it'll be dropped soon. Yeah, it'll be dropped soon. It's going to drop soon. It'll be on the Three-Headed Dragon.
Yeah, it's going to be on that Three-Headed Dragon.
So, because I thought it sounded perfect, but they are fucking
yeah,
now,
yeah, you know, we got to make sure it sound pitch.
But I respect that. I respect that. Like, you know, see, Christian, you see, easy, you know, y'all went put together, you feel me?
Yeah.
We picky, you feel me? You know, like my shit, I'm picky with my designs, you know what I mean?
What we look at is like, what might be good to our ear might not be to everybody else's, you know what I mean? We got to have a digital worldwide ear. We can't just have a stationary ear on what sound good to us. We got to think outside the box. Is this going to be clear enough for everybody else? Is this going to be, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that's a lot of reasons why we really be hella picky on the mixing. Because it's like, that be the most critic. Like, you can have a dope ass song, you know what I mean? And if it ain't bounced down, mixed down right, you know what I mean? If it ain't going to be no dope ass song, you feel me?
It ain't. If the levels ain't right, forget about it.
Yeah, like I only fuck with a couple like producers, engineers that like mix and master my shit.
Hell yeah.
That's it's either my boy SB Sir.
Yeah, my boy Sir.
Or it's Block.
Yep. Or I fuck with my nigga Prop.
I only fuck with them three.
Yep, I fuck with my nigga Prop.
Because you know you got a certain sound. You know, whatever certain sound you want, you know what I mean?
You find it, you find it.
And which is cool about, I mean, like I've met all kinds of producers now, you feel me? Like I didn't even know what I was looking for to see what's up, but like me and myself personally, I just like fools that are focused. Like if you just about your craft, I think you could do a good job.
Yeah, because, hell yeah.
But if you're slacking and you're not really with it, I'm cool. Because they're just going to waste your time.
Right, right,
And then they're not going to want to do it again, or it's going to take a long.
You know the people that's focused because they got a lot of work catalog. Anybody that's focused, you're going to see their work catalog.
I think everybody has a certain sound.
Yeah.
Because whoever you shouted out right now that just mixed your last tape. That you sir. What you got coming out? You got something coming out, too.
Born in a Dope Game.
Born in a Dope Game. Dropping on
it. SB Sir, he mixed every song on there.
Yeah. What is this? One more time?
SB Sir.
And it blends with them.
Yeah, and I feel privileged, bro, because I just slapped that whole thing today, bro. When Bird
man, clean.
Yeah, me and the whole TaxCity, TaxFree over there, we slapping it today.
Yeah,
that
we was putting the track list together.
That we're putting the right audio, I mean, because it's good, bro. And that's another thing, bro. We collab, man. It's love, bro. I'm telling you, this nigga finishes this. Me and Whoop got the same process almost, but he got the studio at the crib, so I pull up. You, what do I do every day?
Yeah, you're right.
I pull up at 8 in the morning. I'm writing from like 8 to 10 to 11, depending if I'm hella in it. You know what I mean? Sometimes you don't get it, but I still force myself to do it. It's a routine. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And he do the same shit, but he actually on the mic. He don't write. I write.
That's the first time. You know what I mean? So we set up a studio session. That's the first time I ever worked with Will. We set up a studio session over on Wells. Remember? We were on Wells. And this studio is as big as like a one bedroom studio or smaller, you know what I'm saying? Like
this corner we in.
Yeah,
right
like small, you feel me? And there was about 15 of us in there. No bullshit. Like 15. And we was in there. It was cool as fuck. It was cramped, but we was vibing.
Hell yeah.
So they went in the booth and they were punching in. Punching in, come out, punch in, putting up, put it in. I was like, what's happening right now? You know what I'm saying? They made a whole fucking song, freestyling, drop few bars, cut it, and then do it again, and then come again. And he records faster than motherfuckers got shit written down.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So that's big. My boy be going crazy, bro.
Hell yeah.
Respect,
hell yeah.
You know what I mean? For anybody that's ever been in the studio, for you wannabe rappers and shit, I'm just telling you, If you make music, you know how difficult that is. You know what I mean? You can sit here and be like, I'm a natural, I'll go in there bang it out. Yeah, I guess. But, you know, it's hard.
It ain't easy.
You know what I'm saying?
It took me a minute to get like that, though, because I started off writing. You know what I'm saying? I started off writing. But I just really got on that process probably like last year, 2008. But no, I'm tripping. What year we in?
So he don't know what year we're in. So we're in 2022.
2022.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. I'm back on pace now.
Hold on.
But yeah.
Hold on.
Oh shit.
Hey, cover the label because that's 7-Eleven. Hey, I'm not even supposed to say that. Hey, shout out 7-Eleven. No, I love 7-Eleven.
I go with the burrito and a big cup of cheese.
Cup of cheese.
bro, I really started off freestyling. Bro, I used to write. He the one set me down. Had me start writing. You feel me? He didn't freestyle for nothing, bro. Like, it just really, like, adapted to him. Like, he always write fast, though. Like, even when he used to write, he didn't, it don't take him long to write. He write fast as hell like this.
Your ideas are coming.
So, even when he write, it's like the shit comes so fast. He damn near freestyling already, just but you on said the you, paper. You know
coming,
what I mean? Like,
you coming deep on this one.
You said this whole tape is different for me. Like, I really dig in deep on this one. Like, this one kind of special to me too. I ain't gonna lie.
That's cool. I'm honored. You're mean like, to be able to see the process and then be able to hear it. Sure, we the first people to hear it. That's what I love about being in this rap shit, is that I get to hear the music before anybody can hear the music, you feel me?
By the
I love
time, it, by the, time the world slaps some songs, I'm tired of it. Because I'm already done bumped it the whole time, you know what I mean? Yeah, I get it so early. Every time he done with one, he sends it to my shit.
I send,
You know what I mean? I'm like, all right, hey, that's it, nigga. Boom, 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 boom.
I be sending y'all songs by 8, 9 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. Be up hella early and shit.
I wake up at like 5 o'clock. I'm up at 5 o'clock, get in the shower, get out of the shower, go straight to the computer, start recording.
That's crazy. That's good. That's hard. I wake up and I try to work out at 5 in the morning, but yeah, if I'm sitting around, like, they're doing that, 5 in the morning, that's tough.
You know what's dope is, I got my little sound, Whoop got a little sound. But try to pinpoint Hanso's. That nigga's versatile. Yo, hey, you got a sound, and that sound is different.
You want to show him some or what? Should we show him a little something?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Y'all about to hear a little snippet. You know what I'm saying? A little unreleased music. We ain't never done this before. We're going to try to
do your thing. Hold on. Let me open that thing. There you go.
Y'all can show him a little something.
Make sure you subscribe, tap in, comment. Any artists in the city, man, tap in. You want to come in here and show off your music?
Yeah, man, because
get some good footage of you feel me? I'm out here chilling. They smoking. I just say no to drugs.
I'm Medicaid. I got a medical card. Medicaid. Damn, I'm Medicaid.
Wait a minute.
Hold on.
Let's see what we got
here. Oh, shit.
Oh, you bumping that?
Yes, sir.
You bumping that one?
Yes, sir. Man, it's going to be on that new EP about to drop called That Vibe with me. You feel me?
Right.
There we go. Let me see. Give me a little live taste of it too.
See the way that I'm dripping. She say she wanna kick it. Ain't got time for the chilling, baby. I'm chasing chicken. I'm hit the road with a nigga and let's get on the mission. I'ma do the dash in the coupe. You gon' roll up the sticky. My little bitty, that's my little baby. Know she fuck with me. If it's static, I'm pulling up to drop above 50. Drop them diamonds around your neck and now you stuck with me. Keep the love with you, girl. I only want your trust with me. She like the shit I be kicking, so she say I'm the realest. We them niggas get to the chicken, we stack it and flip it. Run through the dubs, stack the hundreds and put up the 50s. Keep the love with you, girl. I only want your trust with me. If I'm sliding, is you gonna shoot and drop the whole 50? Okay. Be my rider, and if I die, is you gonna go with me? Catch a homie, girl. Is you down to snap the soul with me? Girl, don't fold with me. Something I really wanna know, really. And can you hold it down while I'm gone? No, I'm hungry, so I be eating up the road. Never lonely, I keep a pound in my coat. Let them try me, I'm down to snatch a nigga's soul.
I cut it, cut it. That's too much. That's too much. Goddamn. That shit going hard.
Oh, yeah, man. Hey. That's when it dropped. You feel me? Stay tuned.
Christian, what you think?
Motherfucking Hancho.
Clean, right? Clean round. I'm excited. I had to turn it off because y'all got a man. That was free. That got no more.
Y'all can't get
you gotta
too much.
You got to stream that shit.
You can't get too much. You got
that shit cool. Maybe your Hancho.
Maybe your Hancho.
Hey, I love that. I love that bar and shit. We eating up the road.
Sir, we eating up the road, man.
Shout out to the
man, you feel me? Go subscribe.
The world one said shotgun. Y'all a big part of what we do. You feel me? If Roadrunners know if you get a good passenger, that's key. You feel me? I hit every fucking state. If I had a good ass passenger,
eating up the road.
If you know, you know. You feel me? Hey, and if you switch your seats, if I trust you to hop in the driver's seat, you're very special. Or you don't know what's in the trunk.
I
had that surprise. We was running with what? I was like, shit. It's done already, anyways.
And we here, right?
We here. We made it. Don't worry about it.
ABM Hancho. ABM Hancho.
I got one of us three, man.
Yes, sir.
This one's off his album, man.
So this one got Whoop, Hunt,
me,
and Richie.
Oh, that's packed out off that Born in the Dough game.
Packed out. Yes, sir. Born in the Dough game. Drops,
October 20th.
Yes, you sir.
On my birthday. So y'all don't forget to get
and you get a little live sneak peek.
Don't forget
to get. I was raised in the trenches. All that plan, get a nigga name engraved in the pen. Shit with dudes, whip it out with my brother. Spinning Glock, if we don't see him, we double right back. He high capping on the ground, so we spilling his hat. Doop, 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 doop. Bullets flying out the mag. He try to run and he be Ricky, they eating his back. I'm a god in the trap, I don't pop with the rap. And how the fuck is that your man? You know you're a rat. Little thot bitch, bust her down while I'm at the trap. Big Glock spit, laying down like he was a mat. Dog strong, got a bark on it, it bite back. Don't send no trash beats, I'ma send them all right back. He try to be a superhero, he got his life snatched. Put a nigga on the poster just for thinking he like that. One up top, when I ride, know that he cock. He died cause you pump your mans up, he had a Reebok. Trapped out jumping, at a certain Knox re-rock. 10-piece gone, another play out in Turlock.
Up all night, let me serve another fiend.
And it's the homie Richie, man, Richie on, man. You feel me?
What he say?
Richie on, I'm the king. Oh. All right, they got to stream that one, too. They got to stream that one,
y'all
got
to stream that, too, man.
And we got to let Richie fucking do his part.
You feel me? Yeah, that's the homie all. Richie, you feel me?
That's that packed out, man.
That's that packed shit. Out.
This whole tape pressure, man.
I said she tried to hit my ass and told a bitch pick a lip.
You feel me? What I told that nigga?
You're a freaky motherfucker.
Look, speaking of freak, we was talking about some shit earlier and shit. And then the dugout. We got to talk about the dugout now. Because he's talking about licking and freaky, freaky.
What's home with a...
So look, we was in high school, right? We was in high school, right?
This is the boom boom room.
This is the boom boom room for us. You feel me? Let me like the post.
Let me the end. Let me like the new post.
Yeah, like the new post. Let me like the new post because we talking about the dugout. Look, man, bro, I tell you. I came into high school. I was a saucy ass freshman.
There you go.
I was always saucy.
He was a dancer and shit.
I grew up under these niggas.
He was a dancer.
Like that.
No, you know, back then.
Chris Brown, I'm turfing. Back then. I'm doing all that. But I got gigs.
Come on, let's see.
Oh, I got gigs. What?
Little top.
What? I got super gigs.
You know, back when we were bone
breaking. We still bone breaking and all that. We're not gonna get into that. You feel me? But y'all know what I mean? Besides that, look, growing up with these niggas already.
When
I was in seventh grade, eighth grade.
Sick.
Man, eighth grade, these niggas already had the high school popping. So it's like my big brothers is already, you feel me? So when I get to high school, I'm already saucy.
Yeah.
My big brother
know you coming and shit.
My big brother's known. You know what I mean? I'm just dancing ass, fresh ass nigga. You feel me?
Good times. High school's good times.
So, man.
Yeah, I be missing.
We having a little Jones everywhere. I'm talking about everywhere. And we having a tree. All the little shit. So, nigga, we having a Jones 24/7. I'm talking about, bro. We had the little spot. The little dugout. You feel me?
The dugout.
We had a little certain days.
We're in the baseball dugout.
Yeah, we in the baseball diamond.
In the batting cage.
In the batting cage. We so thuggy with it, we in the batting cage. Look, we had certain days. Everybody will link up.
Hold on before you say this.
Look.
Before you say this. My brother girlfriend dad.
About to get deeper.
He was the baseball coach and shit.
Yeah. Oh.
And he's still with his girlfriend, but he was never at that. He wasn't over there. Okay. But he was over there smoking. But he wasn't over there doing what this nigga was doing.
And what was you doing?
He was on
for real.
He was showing up in
pajamas,
shit.
You saying?
Yeah, look, man, we had little days and shit. You feel me?
pajama
days and shit.
How many girls you smashed in the dugout?
Oh, about like 15.
How many got dugout?
Really?
Bro, what was that?
That's a handshake, right?
What was that? 15?
That's a handshake. 15. Freshman year. Freshman
year. That old vision.
Let me get the. I'll name a few of them.
No. No.
Look. I'm finna blow. She gonna
hit my heart. Gonna hit you. Yeah, exactly.
Look, but like I was saying though, the dugout was the link up spot. You feel me? On my mama, all the little Jones. If you was popular, bro, you had some jumps. You feel me? You doing your little player thing. When it's time for you to cut off fourth period after fourth period, you know, fifth and sixth period don't exist.
Oh man!
After fourth period, it's time for a nigga to, you know what I mean?
Getting
the
lunch.
After lunchtime, it's time to get in the player mode. You know what I mean? So a nigga get locked in, get in the player mode. That's where everybody at the dugout. You'll think the school dry.
We still asking about random ass questions. So how many? Look, I just weird.
Let's hear.
Yeah. How many girls you think you smashed in freshman year high school? Off the top
he
of the dome.
15, nigga. He dropped out.
No. Hell no. That was only in the dugout. That wasn't at the house.
That was just in the dugout freshman year.
Because, my numbers weren't that spectacular freshman year. I ain't gonna lie. My freshman year wasn't that crazy.
I had some crazy.
How much years in high school did you do?
I'm just talking freshman.
All four? Okay, just freshman.
Just freshman.
So that 15 you talking about, was that the first year?
No,
he did 15 in the dugout. 15 in the dugout freshman year. That was freshman year.
Oh, shit. Okay, yeah. Okay.
Did you do different 15? Like, I mean.
Yeah, that wasn't all total, but.
What do you think? What are you thinking, freshman?
I say about like a good 23, 25.
That's a big number, bro.
Ooh, Jordan, I mean,
y'all think Jordan over 23?
Y'all doing Jordan numbers?
Wait, hold on, I got a question. So,
because I was having females from other high schools come to high school.
Do you consider yourself a slut or a slut maker?
Oh, I'm a slut maker.
Slut maker.
I'm just saying. Okay. So what?
Because I turn bitches that's not sluts into sluts.
Oh,
I'm a slut maker. It could be a nerd bitch.
Okay. Yeah, slut is not a bad word. It's not.
That don't mean you a hoe. You a slut. I just make you nasty when I want you nasty.
Yeah.
And I give you props, man, because I keep it that way.
Yeah, you're not a hoe if you a slut. You just a slut. I just make you nasty when I want you nasty.
I give you props on that because I keep it that way.
Spit your mouth and
so
I'm
a slut.
I love sluts.
I'll make them. You make them?
Yeah.
All right, nigga. So you the nigga that be making them for me.
Oh, yeah. I'll make them and just kick them on to the side.
I can't. I don't know.
I'll make them and tell them, hey, look, I know where you can go after. Go to my brother, baby. It's 2-for-1 special. So I'm gonna make you, bitch. He gonna break you.
So are you a slut or a slut maker?
I'm a married man.
Okay, good.
There you go.
Respect. What about you?
I don't get that. What?
You don't get it. What? Wait,
what? I'm a slut maker.
He got quick.
I don't make slut.
Hey, this is real time
shit. Go, hey.
My dog's over here fucking interrupting, but we're going to try to
talk to you. Hey, listen, buddy.
Hey,
that's the big one.
Oh, he got over there.
So then
we were saying what?
No, so how many you think you got in freshman year?
I'll be real with you, man.
Be real with me.
I don't lie like that and shit, bro. I was always a big little nigga and shit, right? So in freshman year, that's when I got with my ex-wife, but at the time she was my girl, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I got with her and fucking, I was going to cat, man. I fucking lost my virginity with her. And she lost hers with me, man. I'm fucking...
That was freshman year.
Yeah, and then after that...
You were with her.
Yeah. And then after school, and I ain't even gonna lie, bro. I mean, I had one of the baddest bitches in school, nigga. So, like...
That's how...
So I didn't have to... And the cool thing, shout out, because she did boost my shit, nigga. Because at that point, everyone was like, how the hell this fat motherfucker?
That's when you became big ass.
That's how I was when I was fucking with Ebony.
Nigga,
you heard me, Rick?
Hold on. Let's talk about Big Happy.
Are we doing this?
Yeah, he's doing it, bro.
Let's do it.
Whatever.
My first name, bro. So
Big
like,
Happy?
Yeah, I came out and started whole fresh shit, boom. But I got the nickname Big Happy. I got a whole fucking catalog under that name. A whole catalog. That's the first half of my rap career. And that's when I was like the stoner nigga, you know what I mean? And like, just trapping tree and like the fun shit, you know what I mean? Not the crazy shit. And then,
nigga
goes through shit. Nah, before that, then nigga goes through shit. And
Maturity.
Shit happened. Yeah, the maturity. World happens. Yeah, maturity and shit happens, man.
You mature with the world. You know
and everybody gets older at different times.
At different times.
Yeah.
Maturity ain't got no age on it.
So, like, and then that shit happened. I mean, and then, wait, what was I saying? I lost my train of thought.
Big Happy, your catalog. So it's before prison.
Yeah, it was before prison. Then I got crazy. I mean, and then I fucking started trapping hella, man. And my shit, I'm going to be real with everybody, was Spice.
Right.
Man, so like, This was like 10, 15 years
ago. For y'all that don't know what spice is, it's fake
synthetic weed.
They said that shit in Alabama. You know, we from Alabama. They said that shit down there back home. We call it spice or mojo.
Mojo.
Niggas dying on that mojo.
When that shit first came out,
I was looking at
that.
Hey, them niggas out there dying on that mojo.
He
was whipping it up.
I was the nigga behind the scene cooking it, nigga. I was the one that got to, okay, that's a double spray, that's a triple. Hey. And that nigga, you know what I mean? So, like.
Whoever cooking that shit down there in Dallas South, them niggas is dying on that mojo.
That's because them niggas are doing stupid shit.
Hey, brother, them niggas smoking that shit like weed. Them niggas smoking quarters of that shit at one time.
Nigga, and that's
man, hey, you'll see them niggas out there asleep.
See, and that's
permanently.
And I blame, I'm gonna tell you like this.
Damn, nigga, what the fuck happened to look, dog?
That was a big issue in my life. So I'm gonna
tell you. Nah, for real, though. You look, what the
fuck. Hey, no, look.
What the fuck happened to dog?
Like, this is a big issue in my life at that point, because I did that for 10 years. So that was a big issue, because look, whoever sold that motherfucker that drug is fucking it up for me, bro. Because back in the day when people bring out the spice, bro, all that spice. Half these motherfuckers is, oh, they scared, bro, because
that's
why
motherfucker dying.
Yeah, dying.
Motherfucker dying.
Yeah, so now I'm like, fuck, I that just lost
like
now
that's just like nowadays.
And some niggas like, hey, hit this, bro, just to watch a motherfucker trip. And then
you know, you niggas used to, hey, niggas
tell
used
me
to
that
want
ain't
the
like
shit,
nowadays
like,
with the prescription
that's
pills.
Niggas.
Exactly.
I didn't hear
tell me that,
that
ain't like
yeah,
nowadays,
that
like with this new little fan shit. Mm-hmm. That's fucking like a nigga can go to the doctors and get some real pills from the doctors and still be scared to take them because there's so much fentanyl going
around.
Man,
them
that's just how same
up.
Way niggas was dying on spice, niggas dying on prescription pills nowadays too. The same
right.
way, like you get what I'm saying? Because there's so
yeah,
much motherfuckers.
But like
with
you said, they want that shit.
They want that shit.
They want that shit,
which is crazy.
They want
that
shit.
Say no to drugs.
Niggas want to die.
Like you said, real shit. I've gone through. Not just addiction myself, but I've gone through, like, my homies gone through addiction, other homies, their parents, all kinds of addiction and shit. That shit real shit.
Hey,
if you got a problem, holla at somebody.
I was addicted
right now. If you got nobody right now to hit up, hit me in the comments. I'm going to holla at you.
I ain't going
to
lie.
This nigga
tell
you, me and this nigga was addicted to drink. We couldn't stop sipping lean.
Right. It's like pills.
Every day.
It's like perks.
I'm talking about me and this nigga, bro. We have a refrigerator full of nigga 2 liters.
Yeah,
man, every day. Me and this nigga couldn't stop drinking. Like, I'm talking about couldn't stop drinking that shit, bro.
Waking up to that shit.
Going
organs,
like, boy. I'm talking about.
You know how you,
man,
you know how you wake up in the middle of night and drink
shit,
something
nigga.
Like on your
for real,
like,
nigga.
Wake up in the middle of night
like for real,
like,
boy. Like nigga,
that shit. I'm glad I don't fuck with that shit no more too.
That shit was hard to stop though. Like that shit took us
like pills.
Yeah, that shit took me like yeah for real though. That drink serious. You feel me? That's why I be telling all
like said
nigga not paying attention to the kids.
Yeah,
like that shit ain't
you feel me? I tell all motherfuckers that fuck around that lean, bro. That shit really ain't healthy for you, bro. Like it's not.
Huh?
Like you know what I'm saying? That shit is serious. You feel me? That shit serious. Like for real.
Nigga be too high to play with his kids and shit.
Nigga don't even be right minded. Like you spaced out. When you high like that, bro, you not even in the world at
hell
that point
nah.
moment.
It's
you
zombie, bro.
You
know what I mean? That's
you,
just you
you're
might
somewhere
be a
else. Yeah,
you know?
Bro, you're somewhere else. You're not even here. Like,
my bad. I'm trying to Google a word real quick, but y'all keep going. Because that shit is real. That shit is real. I'm trying to Google something, make sure. But because addiction will fucking drag you.
Yeah, see, and then it's crazy because mine was that spice because I had unlimited access. And at that time, I was on parole and shit, you know what I mean? So, like, I'm trying to fucking smoke something that ain't going to come up on my tip.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, I would fucking, that was my shit, I got addicted to it, man. Because
like you said, you had easy access.
Exactly, and I could smoke
nigga,
it, I could go to my PO the next day and piss. But, like, there you go, man. But, I mean, that shit, I don't
nigga, our uncles was printing up nigga scripts, nigga, and they was there making the lean, nigga.
Right,
we was getting
right.
that shit out the pharmacy.
And no bullshit,
us.
I never had
access to this shit. We can get so much of this shit. It was just hard to stop drinking it. Bro.
I never fucked with it like that. You know what I'm saying? Like I never thought about it. I don't like taking I don't like taking pills. Like I'm paranoid of that shit, right? But I take my ass to fucking Dallas last year, and they fuck with the lean hella tough.
Yeah,
shout
sure.
out to Dallas.
Yeah,
it's a dope ass city. But let's lit. So this fool had a drink, and I'm talking about he was buying sodas every day.
Every that's
time.
How we was
like
in
every
Alabama.
Time we stopped
in Alabama,
he was getting a pineapple fucking Fanta.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and I was like, oh shit,
they really don't got weed like that.
Oh, shit.
You gotta think about it. They really don't got access at weed like that, like we do
the good,
over
good
here.
Weed, yeah.
So what they do is prescription pills. They pop
they
Lord
drink.
Tabs and they drink
and
syrup.
They get that shit like
that's
we get weed.
They get that shit like we get weed. You know what I'm saying, nigga? That's they high. The way we smoke weed and shit, and we got. Access to the shit we got, nigga. They fuck with Lord Tabs and drink, nigga. That's all. You feel
and
me?
My curious
and they get that shit easy.
I don't even
me?
Drink soda.
Yeah,
but it looks so crazy. And the pineapple Fanta, It's delicious.
That's my favorite.
It's delicious. I never had that shit, and it was delicious. He's pouring this shit in there, and he was like, take a sip. Yeah. You got one? You got one? You got that one? Yeah, that shit's delicious.
No, it ain't no drink in there.
But that shit's good, regardless.
That shit was candy.
And I seen him doing the damn thing, and he was like, try some. And I'm like, bro, I don't even fuck with this.
That shit was candy when you tried it, huh?
I tried it. That shit had me feeling so good. That shit was candy. And that shit sucks. Don't do that.
That shit tastes so good.
It tastes good. And it's bad for you, though, because then the next day, you want to hit it again.
You want some more. That's the cold part.
And it's hella bad for your body.
There goes the addiction.
Fuck your body.
Wow, I'm trying to tell you.
Everything that you want ain't what you need.
But like, we'll be
real shit. That's the message for y'all youngsters.
That's what everything I was gonna say. That's my message to the youth. Like, for real.
You
don't need. Like, and a lot of youth, you see these kids nowadays, they 16, 15, drinking lean, popping perks, all that little shit, bro. Like, my message to them, bro, stay in school, bro. That shit dangerous. Like, it ain't really what you think it is like that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Everybody be so in a rush to grow up fast, bro. When you grow up, my nigga, you grown, bro. And you start looking back at them years like, damn, I should have did this, 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 this.
You got time. You got time.
Motherfuckers don't be thinking about that shit when they teenagers because you just want to be a teenager. You get what I'm saying, bro? But
you can have fun without doing
You get what I'm saying, bro?
Like, kick it, party
me
with
growing
chicks.
Up, bro, I wasn't doing that shit as a teen, bro. I didn't start, nigga, fucking around with lean and shit till I was like 19, 20 and shit like that. You get what I'm saying? Like, nigga, I just smoked weed and shit when I was like 15.
We did, I mean, like,
we wasn't popping pills or doing that. We just smoked weed and drink liquor.
Not to get too deep, but I mean, I did hard drugs when I was a kid, you know what I mean? Like, and that's what fuck. So I have that spectrum, you feel me? Like, of I started doing heavy drugs at a really young age,
like heavy
drugs. Like, I like my first drug was like,
and what's the early age?
See, I used to just smoke 14.
Damn,
you know, I was 14 smoking, you know what I mean? Shit, you feel me? So it was like, I was literally, shit, literally. And it was my cousin was 15, this big homie, his homie was 16, you know, and we started from there, you know what I'm saying? It went right from weed to drinking to boom, like right into the thing, you know what I mean? So you hot wiring shit and stealing stereos real quick. You know what I mean? Like, and it was it's part of my life. I was talking to my cousin earlier. I don't regret nothing that happened in my life.
Right.
It made me who I am.
Right. Same here.
But if I can stop someone from going through that, because in that process, I'm blessed that I wasn't lost in it, because I have friends and people that they didn't make it.
Man, who you telling?
They ain't either there. They died. Or they're all whacked out. You feel me? Right. They're all tripping and shit, or can't get their lives together. You know, in and out of prison. And we're blessed. You know, we're able to be here. I'm able to share with y'all. You know, we all went through some shit. You know what I mean? Yeah. So when I tell you, comment if you having some issues with some shit, holler at us. You know what I'm saying? We've been through all kinds of shit. So. I don't want to get too down on it. You feel me? But motherfuckers really been through some shit. You know, and that's why we started this whole movement. You know, because PakCity, TaxFree, everything that we're doing is for a positive uplift.
Yeah,
any record label out here in Reno, or any record label ever, either the smallest to the biggest, like, if you really pushing that shit, like, do it, you know what I mean? You're chasing dreams now,
right,
you know?
Right.
We ain't chasing
dreams. We about the youth, man. We support the youth, man. Yeah. That's what it's really about.
If you're a young rapper out here, man, tap in with me. We put you on, you know what I'm saying? We put you on and shit.
For real, for real.
But back to the bitches. Back to the bitches. You didn't want to say what number you had?
Huh?
Well, you know how many girls?
I ain't really settled down.
Like
high school. Did you ever count with your partners?
Yeah,
like, how many girls
you
did? No, like, you ever like, hey, how many girls you ever smashed?
Man, this nigga had a house with all the females in there. We used to go over there and smash them.
You asked, dude, like, as
I don't know why this nigga acting like he was just a saint. Like,
hey, good numbers, high numbers.
Good. That sound like your boy, huh?
Respectable man.
We had a whole bowl.
Hey, check this out. I got a lot of numbers, so I ain't gonna say shit. And it ain't even that high, so I'm not gonna say
that. I'm gonna keep it real.
Hold on. We had a whole boom.
Like, my freshman year, I really went, I was like trying to figure out shit, you feel me? Because I really, you feel me? No nigga from Alabama, but I was still going
to school. Alabama, and you went to Sacramento?
Yeah, but I came to Sacramento at a young age, probably like 8. But I still was trying to figure out shit, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Especially when I'm a teenager in high school and shit, so. I was like on some, you know, I was on some sneaky shit, like, like hitting bitches, like motherfuckers was like, oh, you fucked her, like, but I wasn't never telling nobody
that.
But it probably was like freshman year, probably like 7, 8.
That's big. That's
ain't big. Not that's compared to this
not
nigga.
Not compared to that fool, but
this
goddamn,
knocking shit down.
That's why I had two. I remember because I had that bitch. I told you the girl I was with, and then I tried to fuck around another one, and then at that point I was just like, oh shit, I was all tripping, bro.
I ain't really.
Cause I fuck with girl, I mean, she was cool.
I ain't really start popping for real, like on that type of level until sophomore year when I was sophomore. And then me and my brother Demario, we was on some other shit.
Demario was the nigga.
Demario was the nigga. My brother Demario was
so there's always that one.
And he's my cousin
was the oldest. Was he still that nigga?
Demario the oldest. He's the oldest brother.
Is he still?
Yeah, Demario the oldest.
Damn near married.
Yeah, he married now. Okay. Yeah, Demario married now.
But he was always that one.
That's our oldest brother. Like, Demario was the nigga that had the sauce. Demario, yeah. Demario was that nigga.
And he eyed her out. He had her, pretty much.
He had them bitches.
That nigga had them hoes, bro.
I'm trying to tell you, he had them hoes.
Basketball star, Florence. And then, you know, we was in the band. He was the band star. He played the drums.
What?
That nigga was dope, man. Demario was that nigga.
He's touching every corner of the
game. Yeah, Demario was that. Yeah, he was that.
Yeah.
So, I was capitalized on his name.
Okay.
He getting phone calls, all kinds of shit right now. Yo, this was popping.
That's one thing, Hancho. Hancho don't know how to not answer a phone. That's the hustle.
That's cool, though. You know what I mean? That is cool.
What's up?
Hey, that was a blooper.
Hey, speaking of that, I be not answering my phone sometimes. I be missing hella calls, bro.
Hey, I'm at the podcast. This is money, too. I'm going to tell
you. No, bro. You got
hella cool. Look, bottle on the fucking air.
So what's up? What we going with it? Let's do something fresh. Let's see.
What? What you want to do? You
want to
challenge?
Challenge? Damn. Oh, what is that chip? You bring that chip?
I ain't bringing chip.
Next time we're eating a fucking chip.
No, the jelly bean shit.
I gotta find it. We'll do that one too.
Man, he didn't bring the chip, so next time.
I ain't bringing the chip because Ernesto was crying.
Oh,
he was talking about, I'm not gonna be the only one doing it.
Real shit. How am I gonna do by myself? I ain't gonna look right. Look right, fam.
That's like, bro, go fight that dude by myself.
By myself, bro. Speaking of fighting.
Uh-oh.
Y'all thugging in over there?
We
ran
the school.
We was packing shit out.
I won. Like, it's my brother. I ain't finna let him fight. He ain't finna let me fight. DeVille ain't finna let nobody fight.
That's crazy. That's like, you know what I mean? To have that many, like, of your family, like, in the same school.
Yeah, we gonna have both our big brothers there. Like,
yeah, but
Demario
was
like,
never on the bullshit with us.
Yeah, Demario was on different type of timing.
He wasn't on the bullshit with us. But okay. Then, you know, when I was a sophomore. No,
ladies, man.
Demario left when I was a freshman.
This is my question. Can you fight?
Yeah, I can fight.
Nice, good.
I can fight.
Nice. Day fight or like fight? Like you Ice Cube or you Day Day?
Listen, I just ask and they gonna tell you like, yeah, Whoop was out here in the club knocking shit out,
putting mitts on him.
I'm not even trying to brag about shit like
that. No, we're talking.
You understand that? Tell you like Whoop.
Pack talk.
Yeah.
What about
these serious? I grew up doing MMA and boxing.
This nigga did. He do MMA.
I did grow up doing MMA and boxing.
Yeah, my granddaddy, he was a boxing coach and shit.
Oh, that's cool.
I grew up doing MMA and boxing. These motherfuckers are nasty.
Oh yeah, you guys are fucking shit up for sure.
These motherfuckers are nasty as fuck.
And my granddad, he ain't had nothing to be fucked with.
For real? I believe you.
We grew up in the ring, bro. In the gym, we ain't had no choice.
Really, Uncle Willie. His name was Uncle Willie.
I took serious at that shit when I was a teen.
I'll be telling him, like, I'm Uncle Willie's son. That's going to be the next tape. Matter of fact, Uncle Willie's son.
Uncle Willie's son.
Yeah.
That was my other passion besides basketball. Like,
my grandpops.
I love boxing. You feel me? And doing mixed martial arts, I love that shit, bro. Like, nigga did that shit all the way from junior high school through high school.
Like that.
Like, nigga didn't really stop fucking around until I got grown. You feel me? Like, nigga. Just really didn't have too much time for that shit. I got into music. I'm like, bro, going to the gym and shit, and I'm cool off of that shit, bro. I just lost the passion for it. You feel me?
You're hella athletic then, huh?
Hell yeah.
You be basketball, all that.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Can we take a timeout? Yeah.
All right.
No timeout? No? Cut it? No. For real? Sorry, it's because I'm looking at you.
What is the timeout?
We got a timeout anyways.
Yeah, now we're whole topic of
fighting.
Talking about high school and fighting and shit.
I was gonna ask Benny, you know what I'm saying? You got pause on you?
What's up?
You can fight? Can you fight? What's up?
Well, I ain't in high school, so I've always been a little big motherfucker, you know what I mean? So look, I catch that nigga with that thump thump, and I got a lot of thump thump because of my weight, nigga. Then I'm on the nigga.
Oh, okay.
But then.
Yeah!
So, what are you doing?
What stupid ass, stupid. I'm high. I'm loaded.
What happened?
Good weed, baby. Oh, yeah. So, look, he was on his phone.
Oh.
Are you going in for the hitter, like the sleeper?
Yeah.
Or you like combo? Bomb.
Yeah, I've done a few like sleepers, but
look, and I'm gonna tell you because my homie, shout out to my homie Eric, that fool's big. He's always been big, and he can chunk him.
Yeah, well, me, I gotta go for the sleeper, because if I don't got the sleeper on him, I'm getting gassed.
That's mean.
You know what I mean? Yeah, that's so mean, like, bro. And I know, so I gotta, like, low-key pre-plan it in my head, man.
That's why you don't throw all the extra, you don't throw all your power in that joint. You gotta pepper a nigga up first.
Nah, yeah, I don't got that much stamina.
He don't got that
movement to it. That much stamina and shit. But yeah, so, yeah, that shit then, but after 16, I just had a pistol.
Yeah, fuck that. Yeah,
put the pistol on.
So was you?
Man, you know, no, I can't fight for shit. I go for the sucker punches. That's me and shit.
For real?
Yeah, I Draymond Jordan pull him. You feel me? You seen that shit?
Man, you
know. We ain't doing all that?
You ain't doing it.
No?
You ain't doing it. Come on, bro. I know you got
it. I got it, like, yeah. No, I don't like fighting. You look, honestly,
motherfucker.
Honestly,
bro.
I'm going to tell you the truth. I don't like fighting.
Growing
up, the youngest, I was the youngest out of all my cousins.
Me too.
Like, I had to wrestle with everybody.
Bro, you got to.
I had to do everything.
You got to be hard.
My cousin weighed 220.
Everybody think they just want to fuck with you?
220, 230. I'm fucking 11. I'm 11, 12 years old, weighing like fucking 80 pounds. And my cousins are on top of me. You feel me? So I'm like, I got to get them off me.
Bro, I was the youngest. I know what you talking about. Everybody just want to fuck with you. You gotta be hard. It ain't no choice.
There's always the, you know, like, and when fighting, it's like a fight or flight shit. You know what I'm saying? Are you the guy that takes off, or are you the one that sits back? And I'll sit back more than I'll take off. You know what I mean? So I'm not gonna bullshit you. Uh-huh. So I'm more likely to get hit. So, and I did. When I was a kid, I was the one. I would get hit first. Right. It was weird. And I didn't like that.
See,
shit.
I have a little man complex. So, like,
same.
When the motherfucker get in my touch range, I'm gonna fire off.
You have to.
Because so I'm already feeling like, damn, you better than me. I'm a little nigga.
Nah, I'm gonna tell you what he do.
You feel me?
I'm gonna tell you what he used to do. Like, when we used to fuck with him and shit, he'd just like try to jump. And he'll like grab your neck and then hold like all on your neck and shit. Like with his little weight and shit. Like, bro, what the fuck is you like? A little finger monkey. Yeah, like, what the fuck are you doing?
I'm telling you, I was small.
That's
as hell.
What the fuck he do.
I ain't start growing till high school. I was short, bro. I was short. Like,
I stayed little, bro. But real shit, I have a good angle since I'm short. And I seen that. Like, when I got older and shit, like, I seen it, you know. I'm small, you feel me? Yeah. So I fucking, you know what I mean, if I hit you from the bottom, I mean, you know.
Yeah.
I just don't like to. The last dude I hit, I hit him hard though. But I got hit hard. I got a bent nose. I got a scar on my head and shit. My kids be asking me all the time.
Oh, yeah, man.
You got jazz beat?
Man, I don't fight.
I remember my cousin Marcus. He that nigga punched me in my chest so hard.
I just fought my big cousin.
Really?
Man,
my cousin made me cry.
I wanted to kill his ass for that shit.
I done fought over 120 some times in the ring.
In the ring?
Yeah, sparring and like matches. Oh, I done been hit hard as fuck before.
Like, really?
Yeah,
Christian, like, you know how to fight?
You know what I mean? I done hit a nigga hard as hell and I done been hit hard
as
hell.
That's a cameraman. You know what I'm saying? If anybody sees me resort to Christian or looking over here, that's Big Poppy behind the camera, you feel me? And you know what I'm saying? You'll see him later on. But can you fight? Yeah, you can fight. He look like he big, you know what I mean? This was tall. I'm 5'5". That fool's about, what are you, 6'2"?
It's also
6'1"?
That's big also.
6 flat? See, so I'm like, you know, I was around some goons.
But like, when I was boxing and shit, I never really been hit hella hard in boxing. You know, it's just hand-eye coordination. I always, like, when I started doing mixed martial arts, I done been kicked hella hard in my face before. Not even expecting it. You know what I mean? Sparring.
Try that shit.
Wow. I'm like, oh, god damn. I had to really catch myself. Like,
I never been kicked in the head.
You know what
like
I mean?
That's bad, nigga.
Oh, yeah, because when I started doing mixed martial arts, I boxed for 8 years. So when I started doing mixed martial arts, I still had that boxing stance. You know what I mean? I wasn't worried about no. I'm not nearly. When it came to like sparring and shit, I didn't really know how to defend the kicks. I still had a whole ass boxing stance. So I had to train my body to get out of that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm just worried about the punches. Man, that man threw that kick. I wasn't even expecting that motherfucker. Woke my life up. Like, when I tell you, boy,
This fool, he used to do it, and he gave me a mask, like one of those boxing things, but it had a cage because he had broke his nose before. So he's like, put this on, because I have a big nose and shit, obviously. But fucking, so he was like, put this on, and then we're going to spar and shit. And that fool was doing MMA and shit. I worked at FedEx, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. One of my first jobs. And that fool kicked the fuck out of me, fool.
Fuck,
I was mad. Shout out to my boy Joe Barrow.
Yeah,
you
say about
in the face, too?
Say about three.
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
Say about after 3-4 years, though.
Yeah, me too.
I got
too.
I tried to cover, too.
Hey, my first time in there, bro, my first week, I'm in there with the ops and the rest, so I'm like, hella ops, nigga. We always outnumbered. So I mean, I'm like, cool, we good. After a week, me and my homies on toes, hitting, I'm mocking, I hit, I'll work it out. I'll work out and shit, boom. And we're on toes, okay, we cool. We got homies on another tier. Bro, 5 minutes before that, they got on us, bro. The odds, they jumped us, bro. And they didn't on us, right? So I fucking push. I'm getting jumped from the back. I'm on the phone. Boom, boom, bop. I push my way back finally. My stepdad's in the tier with me because it's crazy. But my stepdad had raised me from when I was five, nigga. It's my pops. I mean, it's my pops. I know my stepdad's my pops. I mean, That motherfucker was in there with me. And we went on the same bus and everything. It was crazy.
That's crazy.
So look, I'm on the ground about, like, I remember that's I told you I'm all in on one punch, nigga. So I hit this motherfucker. He was a little kid. They sent after me, bro. Mm-hmm. I fucking hit this motherfucker because I curled up. I ain't going to lie. Boom. I got out of my first time in prison, nigga. Boom. Boom, I'm getting got from the back. Not to say, I heard my pop scream. Hey, they jumping my son. In my head, nigga, because we're in intake at that point. I'm there for a week. I push back, bro. See this nigga in front of me? Put all my weight on him, bro. Tell me why I didn't expect for him to fall like that. I fell on top of this motherfucker, bro, because I knocked him out easily. Little kid, boom, he's fucking. And I thought I was going to have to walk this nigga down, bro. We're in prison. So I'm like, all my shit. And he fell.
Timber.
My big ass fell on him, too. Boom, nigga. So now I'm on the ground, bro. Hey, I'm fucking. By then, because what popped me up the little, my homie was already getting got like 5 seconds before me. I just said, stop fighting. So I pop up off the phone, see my homie again. I was like, oh shit. So as soon as I drop the phone, that's when they get me, boom, boom, boom. So then that's fast forward again to when I'm on the ground now. And I'm looking, bro, and I'm fucking out of nowhere. I'm like, on the ground, I got sprayed mace, nigga, he hit me fine. So I'm on the ground trying to fix my shit, bro. And I look to the side, and I see a big old boot coming at me, nigga. One of them niggas got up. I see a bull coming at me, bro. And all my hands is already, by then, the cops can say, behind your back, nigga. Behind you. And I'm fucking like, wiping my shit dirty behind me. Go like this. I look up, see a foot coming at me in a boot, nigga. They give me boots. Nigga, I just, what can I do? I just, braced it. But after that, why would I brace, nigga?
Yeah, they eat that
my stepdad from the back to see, this nigga yanked, bro. Foot in the air, bro. Nigga get yanked back. Halfway through, nigga get yanked back. Stepdad shaved my shit, nigga.
He saved your face.
My face would have been
caved. Oh, yeah, he would have broke your jaw.
Yeah, then they would have left the mark after that. Because when I went back to the, when I went to the hole, they didn't leave a mark, nigga. That might have left a mark, maybe.
Maybe.
Niggas that jump me, fuck you, niggas. Motherfuck you, little ass niggas. Hey, they think they're all tough. What's up, nigga?
Yeah, nah, I got jumped by some Asians, bro.
Asians?
My freshman year, like, we went up with the Asians.
Yeah, I got jumped by some Asians, too.
Really?
Yeah, because that shit went to his school.
That went to my
school. It was even in middle school. That's how big that shit was.
They knew my brothers and shit. Were so they like, we know your fight. Yeah, they was a gang. They was Asian Crips.
MODs.
Yep. Asian little Crips. Like, they brothers went to the high school with my brothers, and they little brothers went to my school.
But they was deep.
They was deep. I'm talking about, I'm chunking them with these little, socking these little niggas up. Like, nigga, but they, bro. That lot, they deep, bro.
That's a lot. When you got a lot of numbers, that's
deep. Yeah, they deep.
That was deep, bro.
That's hard, bro.
I remember they called us, when I got jumped, they called us playing backwoods behind the school playing basketball.
Them little niggas was deep as hell.
Them niggas came out of nowhere. Like, grown-ass men and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, shit.
That's when you know, like, your life just flashed.
That's what I said. I've had the moments. But the foot got in the pocket. You know, they got little feet.
Yeah, shut the fuck up.
You know what I'm saying?
But listen, I got older and shit, but a lot of them my partners now.
A lot of them we really fuck with. We close now. But you know when you young.
Yeah. I ran into fools that we fought with.
I made a lot of money with a lot of them niggas for real.
For real, yeah. When we got older, we started getting it in with them.
Yeah, shout out my nigga Pang and
my nigga Mo. My nigga Mo.
Hey, we already shout it out. You might as well say your name. Where can they follow you and shit? We about to wrap it up,
man.
For another episode. You feel me? Save some juiciness for the next one.
You can catch me at tf.whoop on Instagram. TaxFree, TaxFreeWhoop on all platforms.
You
know what I mean? We're going crazy right now.
You feel me? We turning up, man.
What's your tag?
You can catch me at BlockBoy Hancho on Instagram, BlockBoy_HANCHO.
The music that drops will be on all platforms.
ABM Hancho, ABM HANCHO.
We got catalogs for you on Pakcity 100. You can find all the music there. Shout out to GT Digital and shit, everybody. Sir. You know what I'm saying? Empire. Benny.
Man, if I'm
always a pleasure.
It's always, it's the biggest on the block, bro.
I bet y'all came through.
Hey, he said he been on freestyle. Hold on.
One time before we leave, this is how we're going to go outro right now.
Hold on, let me get mine, though. It's go Benny, on. B BENNY, get paid. All one word. If you don't know how to spell get paid, where the fuck is you?
Yeah, yeah, no, bro, I got a GD. I know how to spell
come
that.
Come on, so anyway, that's AA, and I got the biggest on the block coming out next. So now y'all want me to freestyle? Nigga.
Freestyle.
I
bet you on. You got a new, yeah, give me a new verse, though. You know what I mean?
What you want, homie?
I don't know, but I'm about to record.
I
want to
give y'all some.
Should I record while we're recording?
I'm about to tag it. All right, let's go. I'm going to hit him on some, like, on, let me see. Off the tax free. Off the tax city, homie.
Yeah,
yes,
tax city.
Look, I
say. Hold on. Let me see what you say.
I say, I swear through the cuss with the blammy loaded. Lil' homie wrote a statement. I was sad he wrote it.
Yeah.
He a disgrace. His pa should be sad he wrote it. I owe it to the streets, nigga, for the bag I'm holding. Look, Lil' Boppa, she a freak. I can tell she woke. Her brother must be a thug. I can tell she talk. Man, her ex nigga, he a bitch, tuck his tail when he woke. Tell him blow his head off and leave the blood on the wall. Like, I got a gripping on the pole like the lights went out. They didn't light me then. But now they like me now. I got the pole on it. Don't make me strike him down. They thought I was the plumber the way I piped it down. Hold on.
I'm gonna take a lot of losses as part of the game. Ooh. Bring up the biggest little city. Gotta mention my name.
Hold on. That's what it is,
I
baby.
Watch niggas sold it for a minute.
That's
of fame.
That's what it is.
I leave a shit in park. We're trying to swerve in my lane. Can't let them leave me.
Subscribe.
In the dark.
Comment. Come on. Yeah. We coming next.
Yes, sir.
Soon.
Who knows? We coming in.
We coming now. But we coming back.
Holla at your boy, you feel me?
Yes, sir.
We out this motherfucker. And then the music. Key the music.
You know you gotta do that one that.
He loves that shit.
I was raised in the trenches. All that playing, get a nigga name engraved in the pen. Shit ridiculous, worked it out with my brother. Family fitness, now they finna see the whole fam winning. I'm still on dope, still injecting them serenity. Send my pops up the road, he back locked behind them fences. Nah, don't forget a whole